This time we get the AOHi Starship 240W PD3.1 27600mAh power bank, which is full of technology. With 240W high power output, smart digital display, and multi-protocol compatibility, it redefines the standard of the high-performance power bank. Its selling points include PD3.1 140W, 27600mAh, LCD smart digital display, safety and visual charging state. The specs info is printed on the bottom. Model is AOCP011. Weight, almost equals 650 grams. Dimensions, 170 by 53 by 50 millimeters. The USB C1, C2 can support input of 5 volts 3 amps, 9 volts 3 amps, 12 volts 3 amps, 15 volts 3 amps, 20 volts 5 amps, and 28 volts 5 amps 140 watts max. Both USB-C ports can output at 5 volts 3 amps, 9 volts 3 amps, 12 volts 3 amps, 15 volts 3 amps, 20 volts 5 amps, and 28 volts 5 amps 140 watts max. The USB-A supports output of 5 volts 3 amps, 9 volts 2 amps, 10 volts 2.25 amps, and 12 volts 1.5 amps 22.5 watts max. The maximum power output of USB C1 and C2 simultaneously is 240 watts, which is distributed as 140 watts plus 100 watts. The total output is 222.5 watts. Battery type, Li-ion 6 INR22 of 71. Battery capacity, 21.6 volts 4600 mAh 99.36 watt-hour. Nominal capacity, 27,600 mAh. Rated capacity, 16,560 mAh 5 volts 3 amps. Origin, China. Open the box. It comes with a 1-meter length dual USB-C cable. The two connectors are engraved with AOHi and 140 watts respectively. ChargerLAB Power ZKM003C shows it supports an output power of 240 watts and is USB 2.0 compliant. It features a contrasting design of matte black and bright yellow. The transparent window on the front has an LCD smart digital display inside that shows the remaining power and the input and output power of each port, allowing users to observe the real-time status. The switch button is located on the side, and there is also an AOHi logo. There are two USB-C and one USB-A port on the top. There is also a power indicator light. Blue indicates normal charging mode, yellow breathing flashing indicates fast charging mode, and green indicates low current mode. ChargerLAB Power ZKM003C shows that USB-C 1C2 can support UFCS, QC3+, PD3.1, PPS, QC5, DCP, and Apple 2.4 amp charging protocols. And it has 5 fixed PDOs of 5 volts, 9 volts, 12 volts, 15 volts, 3 amps, and 20 volts, 5 amps. It has 2 sets of PPS, which are 3.3 to 11 volts, 5 amps, and 3.3 to 21 volts, 5 amps. It also has a set of AVS, which is 15 to 28 volts, 140 watts. It has 2 sets of UFCS, which are 5.5 to 11 volts 3 amps and 11 to 21 volts 3 amps, 63 watts max. Our tester shows the USB-A port can support QC 3.0, FCP, SCP, AFC, SFCP, DCP, and Apple 2.4 amp charging protocols. Now, let's take a look at its charging test. When using the USB-C 1 port to charge the MacBook Pro M4 Pro, the power can reach over 130 watts. Other laptops and game consoles only support PD3.0 at most, with a power of more than 90 watts. Phones that support the PPS protocol can also obtain higher charging power, such as Red Magic 9S Pro Plus, Vivo X200 Pro, etc., while the rest are in the range of 8 to 35 watts. Move to the USB-A. The highest charging power is Samsung S23 Ultra, which is 14.1 watts. The charging power of other phones can be roughly divided into two power ranges, 13 watts and 10 watts, and the overall charging power is relatively stable. When the two USB-C ports are outputting at the same time, the output power of USB-C 1 is 118.68 watts and the output power of USB-C 2 is 94.17 watts, which is in line with the official output allocation of 140 watts plus 100 watts. When the three ports output at the same time, the output power of USB-C 1 is 93.55 watts, the output power of USB-C 2 is 85.93 watts, and the output power of USB-A is 13.46 watts. When charging and discharging simultaneously, the input power is 135.41 watts. The output power of the USB-C 1 is 86.81 watts, and the output power of the USB-A is 13.5 watts. Next, we'll use an AOHi 140 watts charger to fully charge it. They will be put into a 25 degrees Celsius thermotank throughout the test. Here is the charging curve made by the PC software of KM003C. At first, the voltage is around 28 volts. The charging curve can be divided into 6 parts. The power is around 135 watts for the first 5 minutes. After that, the voltage drops to 20 volts. Then, the power gradually drops to 97 watts, 64 watts, and 44 watts in turn. It briefly rises to 64 watts before dropping back to 44 watts. The final part begins at 1 hour and 44 minutes, and the power drops to almost zero. It takes 2 hours and 16 minutes to be fully charged. It can be charged to 50% in 48 minutes and 80% in 1 hour and 31 minutes, and it reaches 100% in 2 hours and 16 minutes. Next, we will test its output efficiency. First, let the power bank output at 5 volts 3 amps 15 watts, and the output ends at 6 hours and 7 minutes. The actual energy released is about 79.39 watt-hour. Its efficiency when output at 15 watts is about 79.9%. Let the power bank output at 9 volts 3 amps 27 watts, and the output ends at 3 hours and 24 minutes. The actual energy released is about 90.25 watt-hour. Its efficiency when output at 27 watts is about 90.83%. Let it output at 12 volts 3 amps 36 watts. Since AOHi has designed this power bank to limit the power when the power is below 10% to prevent over-discharge, the remaining 10% of power is uniformly discharged at 45 watts and counted into the total. The output ends at 2 hours and 30 minutes. The actual energy released is about 90.47 watt-hour. Its efficiency when output at 36 watts is about 91.05%. Let the power bank output at 15 volts 3 amps 45 watts, and the output ends at 1 hour and 58 minutes. The actual energy released is about 85.43 watt-hour. Its efficiency when output at 45 watts is about 85.98%. Let the power bank output at 20 volts 5 amps 100 watts, and the temperature protection is triggered and ends at 23 minutes. The actual energy released is about 35.52 watt-hour. Since the test instrument used is in constant current and constant voltage mode, the discharge is interrupted after the temperature protection is triggered, and the input terminal on a laptop or other high-power equipment can adapt, so this situation will not occur. Last, let the power bank output at 28 volts 5 amps 140 watts. And the temperature protection is triggered and ends at 10 minutes. The actual energy released is about 24.06 watt-hour. Now, let's do the ripple test. The lower ripple means better quality. Firstly, let's check out its ripple without load. When the output is 5 volts 0 amp, the lowest ripple is around 16 millivolts peak-to-peak. When the output is 15 volts 0 amp, the highest ripple is around 25 millivolts peak-to-peak. Then move to the ripple test when loaded. When the output is 28 volts 5 amps, the highest ripple is 33 millivolts peak to peak. When the output is 5 volts 3 amps, the lowest ripple is 26 millivolts peak to peak. Overall, the ripple performance is good. Then, we are going to the maximum temperature test. We put the power bank into a degrees Celsius thermotank and record the maximum temperature on the front and back after 10 minutes under 28 volts 5 amps 140 watts load. After 10 minutes of discharge, the maximum temperature on the front is 51.8 degrees Celsius, and the heat is mainly concentrated in the middle. The maximum temperature on the back is 34.7 degrees Celsius. The temperature on the back is much lower than that on the front. According to the above test results, the AOHi Starship 240W's 2760mAh power bank not only can achieve 240W fast charging but also has good compatibility. Okay. That's all the test of this power bank with futuristic design, outstanding performance, and top-tier safety. Please drop a like, leave your comments, and subscribe to us. See you next time. Bye.